Thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Thank you. Nos slujitori ziceau în apresi. De femeile mele de zanere se am din. Dragă ca mai hapă în șoferi, în mai lins, alte mântuare joz. My soul has need after me, thy right hand hath been quick to help me. But as for these banners set off to my soul, they shall go down into none of the parts of the earth. They shall be spent under the edge of the sword, portions of foxes shall they be. But the king shall be glad in God, everyone shall be praised and swear by him. For the mouth of them is stopped that speak unjust things. At the dawn I meditate on thee, thou art become my helper. In the shelter of them wings will I rejoice. My soul hath pleased after thee, thy right hand hath been quick to help me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, who hath come down, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Who hath come down, and to the ages of ages. Amen. O Lord God of my salvation, by day I cried, by night before thee. Let my prayer come before thee. Bow down, thou hear my supplication. For filled with evils is my soul, and my life unto Hades I draw nigh. I am counted with them that go down into the pit, I become as a man without help, free among the dead, like the bodies of the slain that sleep in the grave, whom thou rememberest no more, and they are cut off from thy hand. They laid me in the lowest pit in darkness and the shadow of death. Against me is thy anger made strong, all thy billows hast thou brought upon me. Thou hast removed my friends afar from me, they have made me an abomination unto themselves. I have been delivered out, have not come forth, my eyes were grown weak from poverty. I have cried unto thee, O Lord, the whole day long. I have stretched out my hands unto thee. Nay, for the dead will thou work wonders, so shall physicians raise them up, that they may give thanks unto thee. Nay, shall any in the grave tell of thy mercy and of thy truth in that destruction. Nay, shall thy wonders be known in the darkness, and thy righteousness in that land that is forgotten. But as for me unto thee, O Lord, have I cried, and in the morning shall my prayer come before thee. Wherefore, O Lord, dost thou cast off my soul and turn thy face away from me? While poor man am I, you pumped me in troubles, for my youth gave him been exalted ever something in my distress. Thy furies have passed upon me, and thy terrors have sorely troubled me. They came around me about my quarter all day long, and compassed me back together. Now as you move far from me, friend and neighbor, and my acquaintance is because of my misery. O Lord God of my salvation, by day I cried my neck before thee. Let my prayer come before thee, bow down, and hear my supplication. Bless the Lord, O my soul, all that is within thee, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all that he hath done for thee, who is gracious under all thy iniquities, who healeth all thy infirmities, who redeemeth thy life from corruption, who crowneth thee with mercy and compassion, who filleth thy desire with good things, and thy youth shall renew as the eagles. The Lord performeth deeds of mercy, and executeth judgment for all that are wrong. He hath made his ways known unto Moses and the sons of Israel, and him that he hath with him. Compassionate and merciful is the Lord, long suffering and plenteous in mercy. Not unto the end will he be angered, neither under eternity will he be wrong. Not according to our iniquities hath he dealt with us, neither according to our sins hath he rewarded us. For according to the height of heaven from the earth, the Lord has made his mercy to prevail over them and fear them. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our iniquities from us. Like as a father hath compassion upon his son, so hath the Lord had compassion upon them that fear him. We know it wherever we are made, yet remember that we are dust. As for man, his days are as the grass, as a flower of the field, so shall he blossom forth. For the wind is passed over it, then it shall be gone, and no longer will know his place thereof. But the mercy of the Lord is from eternity, even unto eternity, unto upon them that fear him. And his righteousness is upon the sons of sons, upon them that he was tested and remembers the commandments to do them. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his throne, his kingdom will overcome all. Bless the Lord, all you his angels, mighty in strength, to perform his word, and hear the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, all you his hosts, his ministers that do in Israel. Bless the Lord, all you his works, in every place of his dominion, bless the Lord, O my soul. In every place of his dominion, bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, hear my prayer, give ear to my supplication, and thy truth, hearken unto me in thy righteousness. And enter not into the judgment with thy servant, for in thy sight shall no man living be justified. For the enemy hath persecuted my soul, he hath humbled my life down to the earth. He hath sat me in darkness as those that have long been dead. And my spirit within me has become despondent, my heart is troubled. I remember the days of old, I meditated on all thy works, I pondered on the creation of thy hands. I stretched forth my hands unto thee, my soul thirsted after thee like a waterless land. Quickly hear me, O Lord, my spirit hath takes away from me lest I be like them and forget. Cause me to hear thy mercy in the morning, for thee I put my hope. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way where I should walk, for to thee I have lifted up my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, and to thee my blood for refuge. Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy good spirit shall lead me to the land of righteousness. For thy name's sake, O Lord, shalt thou bring me. In thy righteousness shalt thou bring my soul out of prison. In thy mercy shalt thou utterly destroy my enemies. And thou shalt cut out all that thou put my soul, for I am thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and do not forget thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and do not forget thy servant. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of righteousness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto ages and ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. O our God and our hope, glory to thee.
Then Jesus prayed to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, for the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the Holy Church, the Son of God, and the communion of all men. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who with faith, reverence, and fear of God enter therein, for our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate, and Christ, for the clergy of the people, let us pray to the Lord. For Metropolitan, for Archbishop John, and for their Quakers, Rock, Deputy, and St. Peter, let us pray to the Lord. For the President of the United States, and also authorities and foreign forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Roddy, Andrew, Joshua, Benjamin, Phineas, Evan, Skylar, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for health, for seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, for those under persecution, for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Call in your remembrance, O Holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady, Mary, and all the souls of your Virgin Mary, with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Let us see, and come on, and
ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For thine is the majesty, and thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me thy statutes.
mercy upon us, keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance, our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, never Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto you, Christ our God.
For blessed is thy name, and glorified is thy kingdom, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
That sows sorrows in the south, baptism with tears, the same shall reap sheaves of reviving and ever nourishing joy.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to ages and ages. Amen.
In the Holy Spirit, the fountain of divine treasures, for from him cometh wisdom, awe, and understanding. To him, therefore, be praise, glory, might, and honor.
If the Lord buildeth not the house of the soul, then vainly do we labor, for without him no deed nor word is perfected.
Verily the saints who are in the higher are the fruit of the womb, by the living of the Spirit flourish the beliefs that follow the adoption.
Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages.
By the Spirit was existence bestowed on all creation, for he is of the Godhead before existence, and he is the unapproachable light, the God of all, and their life.
Verily they who fear the Lord are now forever blessed, for they have found the way of life, and then never became the glory.
High priest, as thou seest thy children's children, thy plans around thy table, rejoice and be happy and offer them to Christ.
Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto you, ages of ages. Amen.
By the Holy Spirit, in the abundance of gifts, the richness of glory, and the depth of the great ordinance, for he is worshipful and co-eternal glory with the Father and the Son.
Early in the morning, on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb at the rising. saw that the stone was rolled back, it was very large. And entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, dressed in a long white robe, and they were amazed. And he said to them, "Do not be amazed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He is risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter that he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him as he told you." And they went out quickly and fled from the tomb, for trembling and astonishment had come upon them. And they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid.
Thy cross to be a door of Christ, and thy resurrection be praised and glorified. For thou art our God, and we know that thou beside thee. We call upon thy name. O come, all ye faithful, let us adore Christ's holy resurrection. For lo, to the cross is joy coming to all the world. Ever blessing the Lord, let us sing his resurrection. For in that he endured the cross for us, he has destroyed death by death.
Have mercy, O God, according to thy great mercy, and according to the multitude of thy compassion, God Almighty, have mercy. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my neighbors whom I sin and judge before me. Against thee only have I sinned and done this evil before thee, thou mightest justify thy word, and prevail when thou art judged. For behold, I was conceived in iniquities, and sin to my mother bare me. For behold, thou hast loved truth, and even see the things of thy wisdom. Thou hast made manifest unto me. Thou shalt sprinkle me with this, and I shall be made clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be made whiter than snow. Thou shalt make me hear joy and gladness, and tell them that they shall rejoice. Turn thy face, Lord, to my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Create me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast them out away from my presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, with thy heavenly spirit, establish me. I will teach thy first of thy ways, and the ungodly shall turn back to thee. Deliver me from the guiltiness, O God, that God is my salvation. My tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. For if thou hadst desired sacrifice, I give them. The whole of your prophet thou shalt not be pleased. The sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit, the heart that is broken and humble. God will not despise. Just go, Lord, by the question of Zion, and let the walls of Jerusalem be built up. Then thou shalt complete the sacrifice of righteousness. And the oblation of my God will be shall not be closed upon thine altar.
Glory to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, through the intercessions of the apostles, O thou who art merciful, blot out all the multitude of our transgressions. Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Peter of Trinitas, and Nectar.
apostles, the wonder workers of our fathers among the saints, Deacon, Patriarch of Moscow, and Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of our holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the Trophy Bearer, Demetrius, the Verse Dreamer, Theodore, the Soldier, Theodore, the General, and Venus, the Wonder Worker, whose memory we now celebrate, and the Hetero Martyrs, Ignatius, the God Bearer of Antioch, our Alamos and Eleutherios, of the holy, glorious, great women martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kyriakos, Otini, Marina, Paris, Kiva, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, right, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers who've shown the ascetic life, of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the martyrs Victor and Stephanie in Damascus, Martyr Vincent of Spain, Venerable Theodore the Studite, Blessed Maximus the Fool for Christ, Martyr Stephen of the Chani, King of Serbia, Stephen Ruraj, and Princess Milica and Martin, the Merciful Bishop of Tours, whose memory we celebrate today. Of all thy saints, we beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners, who make our supplications unto thee, and have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy,
Lord,
have mercy,
Lord,
have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy upon us and save us.
Joyfully sing the praises, and I shall rejoice.
Zion song.
My soul is glad to find you, and your spirit has rejoiced in the land of Zion.
Thank you. justice to those blinded in darkness. The passionless on the cross, the light in peace, the life in death, and the resurrection of the fallen. Wherefore do we cry to him, O our God, glory to thee.
Thank you.
is slain, and we are endowed with life. Wherefore, in hymns of praise we cry aloud, blessed art thou, O Christ our God, who is thus well pleased, glory to thee.
Blessed are you, Lord.
souls, for the peace of the whole world, for the good astounding of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who with faith, reverence, and fear of God share therein, for our Father and for the Father Joseph, for the venerable priest, good to be accredited in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan for Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, Christ our God. To thee, O Lord.
Amen.
wisdom, let us attend.
Thank you.
Bless God and the congregation.
Wisdom.
The reading is from St. Paul's second letter to the Corinthians.
Let us attend.
Brethren, it is the God who said, "Let light shine out of darkness," who has shown in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Christ. But we have this treasure in earthen vessels, to show that the transcendent power belongs to God and not to us. We are afflicted in every way, but not crushed, perplexed, but not driven to despair, persecuted, but not forsaken, struck down, but not destroyed, always carrying in the body the death of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus may also be manifested in our bodies. For while we live, we are always being given up to death for Jesus' sake, so that the life of Jesus may be manifested in our mortal flesh. So death is at work in us, but life in you. Since we have the same spirit of faith as he who wrote, "I believed and so I spoke," we too believe and so we speak, knowing that he who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus and bring us with you into his presence. For it is all for your sake, so that as grace extends to more and more people, it may increase thanksgiving to the glory of God.
Peace be to thee that readeth.
Jesus, "And who is my neighbor?" Jesus replied, "A man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho, and he fell among robbers, who stripped him and beat him and departed, leaving him half dead. Now by chance a priest was going down that road, and when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. So likewise a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, pass by on the other side. But a Samaritan, as he journeyed, came to where he was, and when he saw him, he had compassion, and went to him and bound up his wounds, pouring on oil and wine. Then he set him on his own beast and brought him to an inn and took care of him. And the next day he took out 2 denarii and gave them to the innkeeper, saying, 'Take care of him, and whatever more you spend, I will repay you when I come back.' Which of these 3 do you think proved neighbor to the man who fell among the robbers?" The lawyer said, "The one who showed mercy on him." And Jesus said to him, "Go and do likewise."
Glory to thee, O Lord, and 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 glory to thee,
Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Morning. What shall I do to inherit eternal life? This was the question put to our Lord by a man who is an expert in the law of Moses, as a test to see whether Jesus could answer correctly. Our Lord replied, "You know the law, lawyer. How do you read?" And the lawyer answered, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, with all your mind, and your neighbor as yourself." And Jesus simply replied, "Hey, what's the problem? Do this and live." And to justify himself, Luke says, because I imagine he felt kind of foolish at that point, the lawyer asked, "And who is my neighbor?" Of course, we know what followed was a beautiful parable of the Good Samaritan, with our Lord's inquiry at the end, "Which of the three do you think proved neighbor to the man who fell among the robbers?" And the answer, "The one who showed mercy." To which Jesus replied, "Go and do likewise." So, what shall we do to inherit eternal life? Show mercy to those who need mercy. Have compassion for the suffering and help them. Give generously to those who have great need. Treat others with the kindness that you would want to be treated. In other words, love God and love your neighbor as yourself. The fact that love was the end of the law, which was, of course, what Jesus said, all the law and the prophets is summed up in this, love God and your neighbor as yourself. Well, this was missed by so many of the Jews, God's people at the time. For many of the Jews, the law had become a kind of end to itself, or an end in itself. Strict, outward obedience to the letter of the law in every possible way, down to the smallest detail, was the measure of piety. That's how you knew that somebody was spiritual, if they kept the law in every possible detail. Whether a man had love for others was irrelevant. What difference did it matter? Remember the many times that the Pharisees looked down on the less perfect, because, you know, was that an action of love? Hardly. But they felt they had every right to look down upon them because they didn't keep the law as well as they, as well as the Pharisees. Even Jesus himself was publicly scolded by pious Jews for doing outrageous things like healing people on the Sabbath. I mean, they forgot. They couldn't see the love, the mercy behind our Lord's actions. All they could see was that he broke the law. He did something on the Sabbath that he shouldn't have done. And so, this was the problem that Christ encountered. Bringing love, he found the people who were not ready to receive love. And this is not just a Jewish problem. It's a human problem. And when it comes to Christianity, I think we have as much resistance to love as anyone else. Many people fall far short of loving God and neighbor as ourselves. You know, Christians, we have this reputation in the world for being harsh, judgmental, hypocritical. Every time you see a Christian portrayed in TV or movies, you know, it's usually that type of person, a gossiping person, an angry, you know, person, someone, the last person is willing to forgive or show kindness. We may not deserve all that shade, but I think we probably deserve some of it. Christians also have a reputation for being, what I heard one person say, too heavenly minded to be of any earthly good. You know, it's like a lot of Christians are concerned about the doctrines being right or about making converts. You know, that's the important thing. You have to convert people more than interested in feeding the hungry, giving drink to the thirsty, clothing the naked, visiting the sick and those in prison. But of course, we know that we shall all be judged on the last day by how many converts we made, right? Not whether we were kind, loving, merciful, and being sarcastic.
There is also, I think, you know, for many Orthodox especially, you know, we have a tendency to immerse ourselves in theology, patristics, canon law or such, mistaking our knowledge for spiritual growth. But we did this as evangelicals too. The more that you knew your Bible, the more it was assumed, the more spiritual you were, because you could always call to mind a verse to any particular situation. Not that you lived it that way, but you could recite it that way. But the purpose, you know, of study, of reading the Bible, of theology, all this, the purpose is not to make us smart, not to make us wise in our own eyes, not to make us better than other people, but ultimately to help us to grow in love for God and for our neighbor as ourselves. And the only true way that we can grow in love is through repentance. Repentance. See, if we read, we study in order to aid our repentance, then it's useful. If we read or study just to be smart or puff ourselves up or win every argument, it benefits us nothing. Repentance. What is repentance? Of course, this moving toward God is life. Repentance is another word for life, the way it's meant to be lived. To be moving toward God, to be growing in grace. We need to learn to see ourselves rightly, as we truly are, if we want to repent. Because a person who's delusional maybe sees no need to repent. A person who's puffed up in his pride, who thinks, you know, he's all that, is not going to repent. But a person who begins to see himself rightly is repentant. And when we see ourselves rightly, it's never a pretty sight. It's never something that makes us happy, you know. But we do need to think of ourselves as truly being lowly, to think of ourselves as being nothing special, to avoid self-pity. You see, this is where we fall into this trap all the time. We think perhaps that we're special. Yeah, you know, God won't judge me because I'm special. You know, whatever. You know, I ask, you know, and guys, you know, when we always used to play war games or imagine such things in our head, you know, cowboys and Indians, we used to call it. Sorry about that, but that's what we used to call it. Or we used to fight the Krauts and the Nipponese. Did we ever imagine ourselves losing? Did we ever imagine being beaten? No, we always won. Every TV show you watch, the hero always wins, because that's the fantasy we want. We want to be strong, victorious. And this carries over many times into the Christian realm, where people want to be powerful. They want to be overcomers. They want to be victorious. They want to be anointed. They want, you know, whatever. And in fact, it is, and you know, our aim ought to be to become poor in spirit, not thinking highly of ourselves, not thinking in terms of power. We don't win through strength. We win through weakness, through being broken into little pieces, to seeing ourselves as sinners in need of God's love and mercy to transform us. We need to recognize that only when we are weak is God's strength manifested in us. You know, we try to be smart, we so try to be strong, we try to win out, you know, to overcome, to conquer, to have our way, to be powerful, to make people submit, or whatever. When we really ought to learn to be weak, to be poor, the Spirit recognizes, as St. Paul wrote, that we have this treasure in earthen vessels. We're the earthen vessels. We're modest, humble, ordinary. We are clay pots and not top shelf ones at that. You know, we're on the discount bin. And yet God takes us and fills them with His grace. If we have room for His grace, if we're not full of ourselves, you know, and puffed up, Should we ever think that our religion makes us special, that we are the chosen ones whom God loves more than the sinners? And you know, as evangelicals, I gotta say, I don't know that we meant it this way, but you know how we used to, those of you who were part of that, we used to talk about the saved and the lost. Supposedly as part of our missionary vision. But it created really two classes of people. The saved were the ones that God loved. The lost were hell fodder. You know, they were going to burn. We need to see ourselves really in a certain sense, no different. We are all sinners worthy of the wrath of God, if you will. But when we puff ourselves up, then we lack love. We lack love. Because, you know, God is love. God loves the sinners. Are you a sinner? Then God loves you. Are you a sinner? Then Christ died for you. You know, this is the whole point. And I think in this crazy idea of puffing up and being strong, we like to, I don't know, create this idea of ourselves as being more moral, perhaps, or gravely disappointed in ourselves that we can't stop, you know, whatever sin it might be. And disappointed and losing heart and turning away from God, when we ought to say, yeah, you know what, I am a sinner. I ought to be a little more humble. And not be so puffed up, so deeply disappointed in myself. Like, what am I thinking? You know, of course I am a sinner. Of course I'm going to fail. Of course I can only live if God shows mercy and gives me life and heals me. See, the point of all that we do in the Orthodox faith, and this is what the Jews lost sight of, the point of the law. They got caught up in the law, and they thought of themselves as greater than they really were. And the point of Orthodoxy for us is not to make ourselves spiritual. It's not to make ourselves holy. It's not to make ourselves acceptable to God or better people. Orthodoxy is not a self-help or improvement type of thing. What is it meant to do? It's meant to make us humble so that God can save us, so that the grace of God can enter into us. So do you feel bad about not keeping a rule of prayer or struggling with some little sin? Well, good. I'm glad you feel bad. Maybe that feeling will lead you to some humility, to realize, yes, you know, I can't help myself. God help me. God fill me, God heal me, God change me, God make me what you want me to be. And that's when Orthodoxy is working. Because when we have that kind of humility, then we have great love, appreciation for God. We're no longer suffering under the idea of the wrath of God. We can actually genuinely love him for his kindness toward us. And we're not suffering under judgment for other people. Because after all, I am the chief of sinners. What right do I have to judge others? So, how good it is to abandon the strength and the power and the ego and the sense that we need to make ourselves something. Only the weak, the miserable, the poor in spirit can gain the love of God. God gives grace to the humble. For the strong and the mighty see no need of it. They're off choosing other things. Let us humble ourselves before God, the God who still loves us, and all the world, and become a true reflection of that love in our own life, to the glory of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
All those save us, have mercy upon us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace, with his love.
As guardian always, while our life we may ascribe glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to ages of ages.
Thank you.
remember us all in his kingdom, always now and ever, and to the ages of ages.
President of the United States and all civil authorities and our armed forces everywhere, the Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. Orthodox servants of God, especially for the Archpriest Wayne, for Donald and Gloria, for Wanda, Teresa, Cecily, Emma, Tony, Erica, Jared, Destiny, and their newborn Adelaide, for Emily, for the victims of the fires in California, that they have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon, and remission of their sins. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God, departed this life, especially for Olga Garcia, the Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Grant this, O Lord. blessing of flame is peaceful, and the good defense before the fearful judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant his soul, Lord.
Following to remembrance her all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos in the commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
And to worship thee at every place of thy dominion. For thou art God,
ineffable, inconceivable, invisible, incomprehensible, ever-existing, and eternally the same, thou and thy only begotten Son, and thy Holy Spirit, thou it was who didst bring us from non-existence into being, and when we have fallen away, didst raise us up again, and didst not cease to do all things until thou hast brought us back to heaven, and hast endowed us with thy kingdom which is to come. For all these things we give thanks unto thee and to thy only begotten Son and thy Holy Spirit. For all things of which we know and of which we know not, and for all the benefits bestowed upon us, both manifest and unseen. And we give thanks unto thee also for this ministry which thou hast vouchsafed to receive in our hands, even though there stand beside thee thousands of archangels and then thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six great many-eyed soaring aloft, borne on their pinions, sing the triumphal hymn, loudly proclaiming and saying,
Immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theodore, and Thank you.
from thy holy dwelling place, and from the throne of the glory of thy kingdom, and come to sanctify us, so thou who sittest on high with the Father, and art here visibly present with us. God save by thy mighty hand, who part unto us thy immaculate body and precious blood, through us that will all be. God be gracious unto thee, a sinner, ever is God. God be gracious unto thee, a sinner, ever is God. God be gracious unto thee, a sinner, have mercy upon us.
Let us attend.
Holy things are for the holy.
Thank you.
may be visiting, we may only serve communion to those who are participating members of your God's church. And this morning we have one newly participated, baptized, to serve communion to for
with the fear of God and faith,
love draw near. thy people and bless thine inheritance.
We have seen
be the name of the Lord.
mercy of the Lord and his mercy come upon you through his grace and love toward men, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God, and our hope. Glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
From the dead, Christ our true God, through the intercessions of his all immaculate and all blameless Holy Mother, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and all laudable apostles, of the Father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we've now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing Father, St. Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, Menas of Egypt, the martyrs Victor and Stephanie in Damascus, the martyr Vincent of Spain, and the venerable Theodore the Stunite, blessed Maximus, the fool for Christ, and the martyr Stephen of Jechani, the king of Serbia, Stephen, Bushrush, and Princess Melikan, and Martin the Merciful, Bishop of Tours, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints. Have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he is good and loveless, man, with the prayers of our Holy Father, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.